when we are joining the particular array, what and all we are getting? We are just getting the further proper solution for our thing. For example, sorting the array, when you are dividing and when you are combining, we are getting the proper solution. The same way, when you are going for maximal and minimal identification, we going to do the same process. So today, yesterday we discussed on binary search. So today we going to discuss on identifying the maximal and minimal value from the given array with use of divide and conquer method, divide and conquer technique, we can tell. Okay, so are able to see the screen what I am shared with you students? Are able to see the photo screen what I am shared with you? Okay, so this is a simple example I want to teach you with use of divide and conquer method. So let's see list of array we are having. So 5, 7, 1, 3, 4, 9, 12, 6, 2. So this is the list of array we are having, array values we are having. The array starts from 0 to 7. So totally 8 values we are having. So the array will start from 0 until 7 we are having. So what we are doing at first, we are just identifying the mid value. So we are just identifying the mid value. So what we are doing, we are just doing with 0 plus 7 divide by 2. So the formula what you are doing is I and j value we are taking. The I value will be the first position value, and the j value what we are having is the last position value. So I plus j divide by 2, that is the formula. So when you are doing that, 0 plus 7 divide by 2 we are having, 0 plus 7 divide by 2, it's we are getting 3.5 as result. So just remember, we are taking the first position of the array, that is 0, that is come as I, and the last position of the array, that is come as 7. So 0 plus 7 divide by 2. So here, when you are doing this operation, you are getting 3.5. So 3.5, whatever you are having, that will be the mid element. So mid element 3.5 we are not able to take as it is, so that we have to take 4. So first 4 element will be come in the right side of your array, and second 4 element will be come in the left side of the array. So left side you will get 4 elements and right side you will get 4 elements. So that is the first split up we are doing. So what is the left 4 elements? We are getting the first 4 elements, so that 5 7 3 4 we are getting as a first 4 elements will come in the left side of the array. So second 4 elements 9 12, 6, 2, this will become in the right hand side of your split up. So two split up we are doing according to the given formula, so that we are getting two different split ups. So left split up and right split up. Again, we are further moving with the split up here. So here, this will be taken as the split up. Actually, when you are taking the split up, again the first two elements will be come in the left side and second two elements will be come in the right side. So 5 and 7 will be come in the left side and 3 and 4 will be come in the right side. So again we are taking the split up of this right hand side array elements. So 9 and 12 will be come in the left side and 6 and 2 will be come in the right side of this side. So we are just splitting the entire array into something. Okay, so again we can further splitting into the single elements, that we are not doing here, that we done in the sorting of array we discussed in the first exercise. There we done with single element, then while you are merging, you are sorting and merging everything. But here what we are doing, we are just identifying the maximal value and minimal value from the given array positions. So what we are doing, maximal value from the given array, so we are getting 7. So what is the maximal value in the given two elements? That is 7. What is the minimal value in these two elements? 5. So we are identifying max value as 7 and min value as 5. So in this two, what is the max element? Can you tell me? In this two, what is the max element?
4.
What is the max element? 4. 4 is the max element. So 4 we are writing here. So min element is 3. The same way, 9 and 12 we are having. The max element is 12 and min element is 9. The same way in the last one, we are having the max element is 6 and min element is 2. Okay, so Until this, we are identifying the max and min value from the given list of split ups. Then what we are doing, we are comparing this two max and min values. So this max value and this max value we are comparing. So which is the greater max value we are identifying, so that we are concluding the max value finally. So this max value is 7 and this max value is 4. So comparing these two max values, we are identifying that the 7 is the highest max value, so that we are identifying max equal to 7. Next to this, we are having the min value. We are comparing these two min values, 5 and 3 we are comparing. So 5 is the greater value, so 3 is the minimal value. So while comparing the minimal value, which is the least value that we are taking, so this 3 will be come here. Okay, so the max value is 7 and the min value is 3. The same way, here we are comparing these two max values. While you are comparing these two max values, the max value is 12. Here also the max value is 6. So we are getting the max value as 12. When we are comparing these two elements as min value, 9 and 2 we are having, the minimal value is 2, so that the min value has come as 2 here. The same way, we are identifying the solution from this 4 and we got 2. Now we have to compare these two to identify the final solution. So what we are doing, we are taking the max value here as 7 and here as 12. So among these two, when you are comparing the max value comes as 12, the greater value. So it is 12. So we are identifying the max value as 12. So min value here and here we are having. So min value is 3 and min value is 2 here. So we are finding the least value among these two. So the least value is 2. So the min value we are identifying as 2. So did you understood this particular example, students? Did you have any doubt in this particular example? Did you have any particular doubt in this example? Please inform me. I will rectify your errors. I will rectify your doubts. So what we are taking? We are taking the entire array. We are taking the first position as I and the last position as J. We are doing the formula I plus J divided by 2. While you are doing I plus J divided by 2, we are finding the mid element. So mid element, with use of the mid element, the first part and second part will be splitted. Again, the further split up we are doing, two elements we are getting actually. And when you are comparing this two elements, we are just taking the maximum and minimal of those elements, and we are just putting the max and min element. And the same way, we are identifying the max and min element, and we are identifying max and min element for all the divisions. And further, we are comparing the max values and identifying the solution, first level of solution. And here we are identifying the max value and min value and identifying the first level of solution. Again, what we are doing, we are comparing the first level of solution and identifying the final answer. So this is the way we are identifying the max and min value with use of divide and conquer technique. Okay, I hope you understand this example. Now we're going to discuss on how we are making the algorithm for this divide and conquer. How we are making the algorithm for this divide and conquer, that we're going to discuss. So let's see the algorithm. I'm sharing the algorithm thing. Sorry, able to see the algorithm, students? Are you able to see the algorithm screen, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we are, what I told, we are identifying the maximum minimal value with use of divide and conquer technique. So the algorithm, what we are starting the algorithm with matrix. So sorry, the algorithm having the method name is maxmin. Maxmin is the method name. Inside the maxmin, we are passing I value, J value, max value and min value. So these are the four elements we are passing as a parameter to the algorithm. So I and J, you know, the starting of the array and the ending of the array. Max value represents the, what is the max value we are getting, that is considered as max element. And min value, what is the min value we are going to get, that is considered as min element. Now opening the method, we are just giving I is equal to J. I is equal to J, we are just happening, that is mean by, if you are having a single element in the array. So in the previous thing, we got totally 8 elements, 0 to 7 we have, so that we done that much of operations. We splitted everything and we compared the max and min values and identified finally which is the max value and which is the min value. When you are having a single element, I'm having 5, element 5, so A of 0 is 5. So when you are having A of 0 is 5, what happens? that 5 has to be the min value and the 5 has to be the max value. There is no other option. There is no other comparisons. There is no other split ups because we are having a single element, so that whatever the elements we are having, that will be the final element that has to be fixed as a max element and min element. For that, this code we are doing. So I is equal to j. When you are having the single element that is the same value, then 5 is equal to j, mean by the I value also same value, j value also same value. So here 5 is equal to 5, so then we have to apply the 5 will become as max value and 5 will become as min value. Now when you are going for the next one, so when you are having two elements, when you are having two elements, then we have to go for this code. So what we have to do, we have to go for when the a of I less than a of j. So we are having two elements. In among two elements, we have to identify which is the maximal value and which is the minimal value. In that case, if the first element is 3 and the second element is 5, so 3 less than 5. So 3 less than 5 condition is true. So what it will assign? The second element it will assign for the max and the first element will assign for the min. If it is not, and the condition is true, it will do this task. The condition is false. If the a of I is greater than a of j, it will go for the else part and do this operation. What happens? The 5, whatever, if you are having 5 and 3 here, a of I is 5 and a of j is 3. So this condition comes to false. So what happens? A of I will be assigned to max. So 5 will be assigned to max and 3 will be assigned to min. So that what it will do here in the else part. So I hope you understand this part and this part. Now we are moving for this part. This part mean by what we discussed in the previous example, more than 2. If you are having the array elements more than 2, then we have to divide and we have to identify the solution. We have to compare the solution. All these things has to be happen. So what we are doing, the first thing, we are identifying the mid value. The formula, you know, I plus j divided by 2. So I plus j divided by 2 mean by what? I value will be the first position of the array. J value will be the last position of the array. So that by adding this 2, we have to identify the mid value. So adding this 2 divided by 2, we have to identify the mid value. So previous example, we got 3.5 and we taken 4. So we split up the entire array into 4 into 4. 4 first left side 4 and right side 4. The same way we are identifying the mid value with use of this formula. Then what we are doing, we are doing the operation, the split up operation, so that we are just calling the max min with by passing I value, mid value, I value, j value, mid value and max value we have to pass. So next to this, we are just having the same max and min again. We are just passing the mid value plus 1. We are just doing the same split up again and again. Whatever the split up we done, that we have to do here. So until we are getting the two elements, we done the split up. For that reason, we have to write this code. Next to that, we have to compare the max and min value. So we have to first compare the max value with the next max value. If the first max value is lesser value, then the second max value, max one value, will be set as max value. Then again, we have to compare the min value. The first min value will be set as min and the second min value will be set as min one. So min one is greater, min one is less, means we have to put min one as minimal value. So according to the value what we are getting as greater value, that will be set as max value, and the minimal value what we are getting, that will be set as minimal value. Okay, so this is the algorithm for divide and conquer. So what we discussed until now is divide and conquer with use of the example and the algorithm. Now let's go for the slides, PPTs, so that we can continue the minimal and maximal with use of divide and conquer. I hope you got the basic idea about this divide and conquer. So with use of this basic idea, we can move for the further. So I'm sharing the PPT now. So dear students, are you able to see the PPT what I shared with you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's take this problem statement for min and max. So given a list of n elements, the problem is to find the minimum maximum items. Whatever the minimal and maximal item we are having, that will be identified with use of this particular algorithm. This is a straightforward algorithm to achieve the given below. So what the coding part for the algorithm they wrote here, actually the coding part, what the coding part is, in the place of min-max, they gave straight min-max as a method name, and they are passing four parameters inside the particular method. One is the array, next one is the size of the array, the third one is the max value, and the next one is the min of the value. So what is the minimal value that they are passing as a parameter? Next to that, they are setting the max value and min value as a of 1. So initially the max value and min value they are setting as a of 1. Then further they are iterating the for loop according to the value they are comparing with the particular thing, and identifying which is the max value and which is the minimal value at last. So this is the first level of code they are making. So here brute force max and min, that is one more method they can able to make with use of brute force method. So what the brute force method will do, they are making two of n minus 1 comparisons to identify the best, average and worst cases. And here the comparison will be done by the array positions, whether it is greater than max. If it is false, then we have to improve the algorithm. So here the code will be written like this: if a of I greater than max, then max value will be a of I. If the a of I less than min, then min value will be a of I. According to the comparison, what we are getting, if the array position is greater than max value, we are setting the particular value will be the max value. If the array value is less than min value, then the min value will be updated on the same way. So first of all, we are taking the particular work with the half the time what we are doing for the other comparisons. So the comparison will be taken as 3n divided by 2 minus 1, the average number of comparisons. If you are having n number of values, what is the average number of comparison that is calculated as 3n divided by 2 minus 1. Now next to this, we are going for the divide and conquer strategy, how the algorithm is happened. So let's see this. Whatever we discussed in the previous algorithm, the same algorithm they represented here. So void max min, so I value and j value. I value represents the starting of the array and j value represents the ending of the array position. And max value, what we are having is maximal number, max defines the maximal value in the particular array. Min defines the minimal value in the particular array that we are passing as a parameter. Next to this, we are just comparing the two values, I is equal to j. That is mean by, if the, we are having very single element, a single element as an array, where we are having only one element in the array, then we are doing this task. So that if we are having 5 as a single element, 5 equal to 5, condition is true. So max value and min value will be 5 only. So that a of I is assigned to max and min value. The next condition, if you are going for the next condition, if you are having two elements, then we are going for this particular task. So what is this task? If I is equal to j minus 1, the second value will be compared. And if the both the first element is 5, the second element is 3, means 5 less than 3, condition is false. So what happens? It will go for the else part and assign a of I as max value. So 5 will be go for max and 3 will be go for min. If you are having 3 less than 5, in that case, the a of I will be go for min and a of j will be go for max. So if a of I is 3 and a of j is 5, in that case it will go max will be a of the max value will be a of j and min value will be a of I. So max value will be 5 and min value will be 3. Okay, so this is the algorithm for single element and two elements. So here they are going for the multiple elements as we discussed in the previous example. So what they are doing, they are doing the split up. So if the small case and the another small case, what we discussed in the previous slide, that they are given here. So here the divide and conquer, if more than two elements, then they are dividing the value. They are identifying the mid value, I plus j divided by 2. So mid value is identified. According to the mid value, they are doing the split up. And further, they are comparing the max and min values and identifying the final max and final min values. So the else part will do everything. So we are having else if ladder, the if condition, else if and else we are making. So according to the conditions, it will go for the statements. So the example they given for understanding purpose, we seen one example. Let's take this example further. So what the example they are given? So the values what we are having, 22, 13, minus 5, minus 8, 15, 60, 17, 31, 47. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here the split up will be going like this. So according to the split up, they are making the comparisons. So what they are doing, they are making the split up like this initially. So how the split up was 1 2 22 13, and here 3 3 minus 5 minus 8. So here they are making the split up as different thing, the positions and the values they are giving. So first position and second position where they are taking, the first position is 22 and the second position is 13 they are taking. So first position is 22, second position is 13 they are taking as a first split up. And here what the split up they are doing, they are taking two the third position two times, -5 -5 they are taking. So further they are comparing this two. So what happens, 1 and 3, 1, 3 they are making. So the maximal value is 22, the minimal value is -5. From this two they are making the maximal value and minimal value, so 22 -5. Then what they are taking, they are taking 4 5, so fourth position and fifth position they are taking, that is said to be 15 and -8. So here the fourth position is said to be -8 and the fifth position is said to be 15. So while comparing this two, they are identifying that 22 is the highest value and 8 is the lowest value. 1, 5 they are identifying. So from these two values, they are identifying the minimal and maximal value. The minimal value is -8 and the maximal value is 22. The same way in the left hand side, they are taking 6 and 7. So 6 and 7, they are taking 60 and 17. So here 8 and 9 they are taking, that is said to be 47 and 31. So comparing these two, they are identifying the maximal value and minimal value. The maximal value is 60 from this, so that is the sixth position, and the minimal value is 17, so that will become in the ninth position actually. So 17 will be here, that is a mistake here. The 17 will be the least value, that will be in the seventh position, not in the ninth position. 6, 7 they are making, so 6, 7 60, 17. Again, comparing these two, they are identifying the least value and the highest value. 1, 9 they are identifying. So 1, 9 60, -8 they are making in this way. When you are taking this particular data, you apply our thing, you split, you identify I plus J divide by 2 and split the values, and just split furthermore and just compare the max and min value, you will get the final solution. So you can approach that way to identify the max and min value. So here this is the another way they are identified, the max and min value. This is for understanding purpose. So let's discuss the time complexity, what we are having for this algorithm. So the time complexity T of n can be written as T of n divided by 2 plus T of n divided by 2 plus 2. So that will be n is greater than 2. If the n value is greater than 2, what we discussed in the exercise, what I shown in the first image, if the n value is there, the n value is 7. So if it is n value is greater than 2, we have to split the values. For that, the time complexity will be given like this: T of n divided by 2 plus T of n divided by 2 plus 2. This is the formula for time complexity when the n value is greater than 2. When n value is 2, we are having only 2 elements. On that case, our time complexity will be 1. When you are having the n values 1, you are having only one single element. On that case, our time complexity will be 0. So these are the three different cases we are having as the time complexity. So when you are having the time complexity, the n value as 2 power k. So the k is some positive integer. On the time, we have to apply the time complexity and we have to identify the time complexity like this. So 2t n divided by 2 plus 2. So this one, whatever we are having n greater than 2, in that formula we are identifying. So adding this 2, we are getting 2t n divided by 2 plus 2. In that, what we have to do, the n value we have to substitute as 2 power k. So n value we have to substitute as 2 power k. So here, what the 2, whatever the 2 we are adding, so 2 plus 2 we are adding, we have to multiply the 2 in front of the 2t, and we are getting 4t n divided by 4 plus 4 plus 2. So here further solving this, we are getting 2 power k minus 1 plus 2 power k minus 2 equal to 3 of n divided by 2 minus 1. So 3 of n divided by 2 minus 1 is the final answer. So the straightforward method we are getting as 2n minus 2. So whatever the final answer, if you are having 2 power k, the n value is 2 power k, we are getting the final answer as 3n divided by 2 minus 2. So that finally we are getting 2n minus 2. That is the final answer we are getting for this given problem. So this is for the time complexity what we discussed. So students, until now we discussed on maximal and minimal for identifying with use of divide and conquer. So divide and conquer will play a major role in identifying maximal and minimal value in different problem statements. Whatever the problem, real time problem you are taking, if you want to identify the minimal and maximal value in very least time, divide and conquer method will be very much useful in that particular work. So let's move for the next one, that is said to be merge sort. So merge sort is a sorting technique what we are discussing actually. So merge sort, quick sort, all these are just taking the elements and identifying the elements in incremental order. So if you are having a list of elements, that has to be sorted properly and arranging the elements in incremental order. So least to the highest value, we have to identify with use of merge sort. So let's go for the merge sort thing. So merge sort is a perfect example for divide and conquer. So we have to divide and we have to conquer. It starts the divide the particular elements in two halves and each will be sorted and it have to be merged and in a single sorted one. So we've seen first example, we've seen the divide and conquer. For divide and conquer, I shown you a sorting technique. That will be the example for merge sort. So let's see the example. I hope you can able to see the screen. What we seen in the GIF file at the starting, that will be repeated here. So we are having 8, 3, 2, 9, 7, 1, 5, 4. So this is the exact array what we are having. This has to be divided. So what we are doing, n divide by 2. So n divide by 2 we are making, n divide by 2 when we are making, we can identify the mid element. So mid element will be identified, and according to the mid element we are splitting the entire array into left side and right side. So that left side we are getting 8, 3, 2, 9 and right side we are getting 7, 1, 5, 4. So these are the split up we are getting with use of the main array. Next to this, we are just further splitting with use of n divide by 2 formula. So n divide by 2 formula we are applying further. So this for n will be 4, here also n will be 4. So here we are getting 2, 2. So 2, 2 we are splitting again. So further we are getting left and right side. So 8 and 3 we are getting, here we are getting 2, 1, 9. The same way this split up we are getting as 7 and 1 and here we are getting 5 and 4. So the entire array what we are getting, that will be splitted into first level of split up and second level of split up, and third level of split up we are going for. In the third level of split up what we are getting, we are further splitting the entire nodes into single nodes. 8 and 3 we are getting, 8 and 3 will be splitted as n divide by 2, so that we are getting 1. So 8, 3, 2, 9, 7, 1 and 5, 4. So until this, we are dividing the entire values. Until this, we are dividing the entire values. And here, from this, we are merging the values. When you are merging the values, we are just getting 3, 8, 2, 9, 1, 7, 4, 5. So the entire value, what we are getting, so that has to be merged fast. So here, while merging, you have to put the least element at first and the greater element at second. While you are merging, if you are comparing this two, which is the least element, that will come at first. And the highest element will be go at second. Same way here we are comparing, 2 will be the least element, 9 will be the greater element. So while you are merging, 2 will be come at first and 9 will be go at second. The same way the third one what we are having, the 7 will be the highest element and the 1 will be the least element. So while you are merging, 1 and 7 will become like this. So here 4 and 5 we are having, so 4 is least and 5 is the highest element. So while you are merging, 4 and 5 will become here. So we got the first level of merging, concurring. So here 3, 8, 2, 9, 1, 7, 4, 5 we are getting. So further we have to merge this. So while you are merging, you have to compare this four elements. So two split ups we are having, the four elements has to be compared. So in this, the least element is 2, and next to this, the highest element is 3. Next to the 3, the highest element is 8, and next to this, the highest element is 9. So that we are getting 2, 3, 8, 9 as the merged one. And this side, when you are taking, we are having two split ups. So 1, 7 we are having, 4, 5 we are having. So when you are taking this, the one will be the least element, and the next to this, the highest element is 4, and next to the highest element is 5, next to this, the highest element is 7. So that we are getting as 1, 4, 5, 7. So this is the concurring of second level. This is the first level of concurring. This is the second level of concurring, merging the elements. Next to this, the final merging, what we are getting at the down, we are getting as the comparison of two split ups, that is it to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. So one is the least element. Next to that, the greater element is 2. Next to that, greater element is 3. Next to 3, the greater element is 4. Next to that, the greater element is 7. Next to that, the greater element is 8 and 9. So that we are getting the final sorted array. The final sorted array with use of merge sort is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 7. 8, 9. So this is the shorted list with use of the merge sort. Any doubt in the students? Any doubt in this thing? We seen the same thing in the GIF file at the starting. While starting the divide and conquer, the same thing. Whatever the diagram you are seeing, I shown in the form of GIF file. I hope you understand there. Again, we are repeating the same thing with use of the diagram. If you have any doubts, please ask me. I will rectify your doubts. So let's move for the next sequence. How the sequence is going for the merge sort. So here, let's see the sequence. So 18, 26, 32, 6, 43, 15, 9, and 1. This is the original array. So this array will be splitted into two parts. As I told, according to the mid element, we are splitting the array into two parts. So 18, 26, 32, 6 will be the first part. 43, 15, 9, and 1 will be the second part. Again, the array will be further splitted into 18 and 26 and 32 and 6. Okay. The further here, 43 and 15 and 9 and 1. So this is the further splitting of the given array. So again, we have to split the entire array into single elements. So what is the single elements we are having? 18, 26, 32, 6, 43, 15, 9, and 1. So in this particular split up, what we are doing until this, the division operation, until this, what the thing is going on is the division operation. So here, the concur operation, that is said to be shorter sequence. So bottom to top, we have to see bottom to top. So whatever the value we are having here, that will be put out here. So 18, 26, 32, 6, 43, 15, 9, 1. So the whatever the splitted individual elements, what we are getting at the last in the division operation, that we are putting here in the bottom. Again, what we are doing, we are merging, we are concurring. So concurring part, what we are doing, while we are comparing 18 and 26, which is the least element, 18 is the least element and 26 is the highest element, that we are merging as same. When you are doing this operation, the second part, 6 and 32. So when we are taking 6 and 32, the least element is 6, that will be put here. And 32 is the greater element that we are putting here. When you are taking the third one, 15 and 43. So the least element is 15 and the greater element is 43 that we are putting here. The last one, 9 and 1. So 1 is the least and 9 is the greater. So that we are putting here. So again, we are merging these two. So when you are merging these two, we have to compare these four elements. So when you are comparing the four elements, the least element is 6. And next to the greater of least is 18. And next to the 18, the greater element is 26. And next to that is 32. So these are the four elements we are having in the least to the greater. So 6, 18, 26, 32 is the merged output for these four elements. The same way, the right hand side, 15, 43, 1, 9 we are having. While you are merging these four elements, what we are having is 1, 9, and 15 and 43. So one is the least element, 9 is next greater element to the least, and next to that 15 we are having, and next to that we are having 43. So when you are merging this, 1, 9, 15, 43 we are getting. So these are the sorted elements in the given right hand side array. So next to this, we have to compare this two set of array elements. So here we have to compare the least element. While you're comparing, we have to identify the least element. The least element among these two arrays is 1. So 1 will be put in the first. Next to that, the next highest element is 6. So 6 we are putting. And next to this, the next highest element is 9 that we are putting here. Next to that, the highest element is 15 that we are putting here. And next to this, the highest element is 18. So 18, then 26, then 32, then 43. So we are identifying the sorted array from the given example. So whatever the example we got, we applied the merge sort, we divided and we conquered and identified the sorted sequence of array. Any doubt, students? Any doubt, students, in this? So the algorithm we will discuss in the next session. So as of now, I will take the attendance. So I hope you understand this particular
maximum, sir. Can you explain once again that maximum and minimum, sir?
Maximum and minimum. Okay.
Yes, sir. That flowchart, sir.
The image what I shown you, no, first one. I will show you.
Not this one, sir. That in PPT you displayed on flowchart, no, sir. With the position elements also.